Good morning, students. Today we are discussing about why, how, and where. In a history, it's a story told by a story about human beings. History, story about him, human beings. He or she, both are there. That is human, both. So our story, when we study, we have to tell where it has happened, how it has happened, and when it has happened. That is why these three questions are given in the history test. You may ask, you may think, why we should study? We want to know. We want to know the background of somebody. When you meet a first time a person, you ask him, what is his name? Where are you from? What are his qualifications? What were his parents? What the parents are doing? So, why we ask those questions to a person whom we meet? Because we want to develop a relationship. Anybody who we don't like to develop a relationship, we never ask. Hello, how are you? Okay. So when we want to develop a relationship, when we want to go deep relationship, we will inquire on all those things. That is part of us. If we want to know how we have come to this present situation, we should know the details. That is one question. How the earth was formed, how the earth has developed into this shape, how the human beings came into existence, how they have progressed. Many of those things, there will be conflict, disagreements, differences, because no clear-cut evidence is available in the hands of anybody who speaks. They are imaginative, speculative calculations done. And we think it might happen like that. There are different versions, scientific versions or religious versions, all those things are there. Anyway, it has come. So from the first human being to the present day human being, we are living. And the first human being to the present day human being, we have divided the history into ancient, medieval and modern. Why? Human being think that there is an end for everything. So after this modern period, what name you will give after some 2000 years ago, then just that will be lost thinking. You don't. Anyway, we have put it as a modern. Ancient, where we have no records, that you are studying 6th class. Medieval, some records, and modern records. Then, after a competition, or after an event is over, in any place, we will sit and discuss the event, we will evaluate where was the failure, where the mistake has happened, which were the successful areas we did, how did we do it, why do we do that? So that in the next step, we will not do any mistakes. A scientist who wants to progress through the scientific inventions, from where somebody has stopped, he should know the other person, how he has come to this conclusion.
So Earth is rotating. How do other scientists has come to know that Earth is revolving, going around the sun? What are this method of calculation? Then only the next person can go ahead from that. Without knowing, he has to start afresh. Take a lot of time for him. So old records, old events, where and how everything is important for the progress. That is why we study history. Date. You think, oh, so much dates. Dates are part of it. You remember your date of birth. You remember your parents' date of birth. You remember the date you joined in the school. Did anybody force you to remember it? No, it comes natural. So like that important things, that is the life of the world, human development, we should know. And if it is a pleasurable way we go through it, and automatically it puts outcomes and gets stored in the brain. Why it has happened? Why changes have taken place in the world? Why the governments were moved? Why the social settings were moved? Why one person is removed from that post and another person is placed? When we know that, we understand what is done, good or bad, its effect is bad or good. Why there was a world war? Why there was a fighting? Why human beings are fighting each other? In ancient history we see groups are fighting each other because one group want to be dominant. That's a human behavior. I want to be powerful. I want to dominate other one. Whatever I say, others should agree. So when a disagreement comes, they try to show their might and impose upon others. Might is right. That feeling was there. But nowadays it is not. Intelligent thinking they use. Different methods they use to show that might of the world. So that is a scientific progress. That is why we study in the history why, what and how. If we don't study why, what and how, we will not understand. Even if Britishers have come to India, they have told, divide the history into Hindu period, Muslim period and British period, because they want to dominate that the Britishers were the more powerful period. According to the ruling class. Here what we understand, they were thinking about the ruling class. So the history is not about only the ruling class. They are part of the society. In any society, any marriage is natural. Who was the head of it? It will come. If you are a house member in Chinese school, you know the house captain. That house captain was good. His period, the things have taken place. Or this principal or this prime minister was good. So all those things are part of it. Any place, the person who sits on the position will affect the activities, his thinkings, his dealings. So that was we should do. So who was having a positive thinking? Who was having a negative thinking? Who was able to lead correctly? Who was leading a wrong way? All those things we should know. Then only we come to know the mistakes and the positiveness of both. Then we can improve. So Britishers want to dominate and say that their period. That is why British period they have mentioned after the medieval period. So thus any society, any progress, any member in the world is like that. So we must remember that. An Indian society, Britishers are arriving, we are going to discuss. Because 6th class we have studied ancient history, 7th we have studied medieval history, and 8th we are going to study about modern Indian history. So naturally, what did the Britishers do? They are thinking the things and the response of the people of India. That is what we are going to discuss in this year. And we have completed. We will give some short notes on all those things. Okay, thank you very much.